Mary, I'm happy to see you today. How are you doing?
Applications with robots interacting with humans are on the rise. And especially we are seeing the emergence of new roles where robots provide not only physical support, but also social support to people. Imagine robots acting as tutors for children in the classroom or in the factory, robots acting as personal assistants or providers of therapy as aid for healthcare personnel. And because of this, many new applications involving humans and social interaction, we as researchers need to explore questions in human-robot interaction to understand how to design a sustainable future between humans and robotics technology.
At the Uppsala Social Robotics Lab, researchers aim to design and develop robots that interact socially with humans.
So we work here both on technical advancements. So we think about how we can use machine learning to improve what the robots understand about the people they're working with. We're also interested in how humans can teach robots what to do so that they can be the best possible companions, apprentices, however you want to think of it. We also do human-robot interaction studies. So that's where we invite people to come and work with the robot and see how they like or dislike different robot behaviors, see how they respond to different versions of the robot. And we do a lot of participatory design. So that's when we bring people in and actually say, okay, we want to use the robot to help you at work. What should the robot look like? Tell us how the robot can best help you. So yeah, we do both sorts of work.
Hey, it's really sunny outside. Why don't you go for a walk?
Well, I'm a bit tired this morning, perhaps after lunch.
That sounds good. Let me know how it goes. Don't forget to put on some sunscreen.
So one example of the work we do here in healthcare is using the robot to guide and motivate people towards a healthy lifestyle. So one of the projects is working in Gränby and Gottsunda here in Uppsala, and we're looking at using the robots to help prevent diabetes in parts of the community that don't normally access healthcare through Vårdcentral. So the idea is to use robots to supplement what's there and use the robots to, yeah, provide a fun social companion, reminding people that they shouldn't eat chocolate after 11 p.m. or maybe they need to go for a walk, things like that.
The researchers also study how robots can support children's development and learning.
I will give you an example. We are exploring the potential to use robots in education as tutors to support and promote children's learning. We have collaborated with several schools to explore the potential for supporting children's development of verbal creativity throughout storytelling, where the robot acts as an educational agent that contributes to the child's development of creativity.